Hello everyone, and welcome to a new day. Today's video is a very interesting topic on the techniques of harvesting and processing kangaroo meat in factories. Without wasting any more time, let's go with us to the kangaroo meat processing factories. Aside from its nutritional benefits, kangaroo meat is also a versatile ingredient that can be used in a wide range of dishes. Kangaroo steaks, burgers, and sausages are just a few examples of how this meat can be incorporated into various meals. First, let's visit a kangaroo farm to see how the process of raising kangaroos take place. The rearing period of kangaroos is a critical time, as it provides the foundation for their growth and development into healthy adults. During this period, nutritionists work to ensure that the kangaroos are raised in a healthy environment under conditions that promote their well-being. This includes providing them with a natural diet and lifestyle that is free from harmful chemicals, hormones, and other additives. As a result, when the kangaroos are ready for processing, they are healthy, strong, and free from disease. After a period of nurturing, mature kangaroos are brought to the factory and ready for processing. A large number of kangaroos are processed every day to meet the consumption needs of customers around the world. However, to ensure the quality of the meat, before the kangaroos are processed, they are carefully inspected to ensure that they are healthy and disease-free. This is done to minimize the risk associated with meat processing and also to ensure that the final product is of the highest quality. Once the kangaroos are cleared for processing, they are moved to the factory where they undergo a series of processes, including deboning, trimming, and packaging. The meat is then stored in a refrigerated area to maintain its freshness before being shipped off to customers. Now, let's explore the process of processing kangaroo meat in factory. Large trucks carrying kangaroos are being brought to the factory. Before the kangaroos are processed, they are checked and classified by staff to ensure that they are healthy and safe for consumption. The factory only uses kangaroo meat after removing all internal organs for processing. The factory is an automated production system that combines skilled labor and modern machinery. Employees on the assembly line perform their tasks themselves, likely in accordance with specific procedures or guidelines to ensure consistency in the final product. The kangaroo is divided into small pieces of meat for easy packaging and classification, and throughout the process, the factory maintains a low temperature to preserve the flavor and nutrition of the meat. When meat is processed by a factory, it is important to ensure that a low temperature is maintained in order to preserve its freshness, texture, and flavor. The factory has to follow safe food handling practices to reduce the risk of foodborne illness. The packaged meat is carefully labeled and packaged by the staff, with preliminary checks performed on the quality and weight of each portion to avoid any errors. The price of each portion depends on the location of the meat and its weight. Ensuring that the kangaroo meat is properly stored and transported can help to maintain its quality and flavor, and help to ensure that it is safely delivered to retailers, supermarkets, and malls for consumers to enjoy. Surprisingly, the amount of kangaroo meat produced by the factory is not only used for domestic consumption, but is also exported to 60 other countries around the world. This highlights the demand for kangaroo meat globally and its potential as a source of nutritious food. Kangaroos are native animals of Australia and are raised on farms for their meat. Farming and processing kangaroo meat are topics that have garnered interest from many people due to the nutritional value and potential environment benefits of consuming kangaroo meat. It is worth noting that the production and consumption of kangaroo meat is a contentious issue among some Australians due to concerns about animal welfare and sustainability. However, proponents argue that kangaroo meat is a healthier and more ethical alternative to other sources of meat, given that kangaroos are not farmed and their meat has a lower carbon footprint than other types of meat. Modern transport technology, millions of sheep, pigs, cows, by airplane and large ships. Hello friends, do you have any questions about how to transport cattle in bulk? Please watch this video. Australia is a country that is considered as the world's farm. Especially the livestock industry ranks third in the world in terms of meat exports. With a herd of up to 35 million cows, meat export is the main industry, so the area of cattle raising accounts for more than 50% of the cultivated area of agricultural land. Beef is considered the main food in most meals here. More than 95.5% of people in Australia use this food. Next, we will see the site of a farm in Australia exporting 3,000 cows that will probably amaze you. After the cows have been gathered, they will have a staircase to lead up to the super large and super long trucks with three connecting carriages, each with a capacity of 80 cows. A two-story carriage, 40 cows on each floor. The cows would then be moved to the harbor where they will be abridged. So that the cows can get on the train and go around the world. That's only for countries bordering the sea. But exporting the landlocked countries, The cows can be transported by plane. Currently, whether it's grazing or fattening, it needs to be strictly followed. Using electronic cart management technology to track and document growth status, activity, to demonstrate meat safety and quality control. Next, let's go to the sheep farm. Australia's land is divided into 5 regions, which are grazing areas. Grain areas and wet climates for sheep farming. The most popular are very large sheep farms with more than 5,000 heads, and the total number of sheep in Australia is more than 120 million sheep. Five times the population of Australia. As one of the leading countries in sheep farming, this is due to the climate and optimal territory grasslands here. Australia's climate is semi-desert and savanna ideal for sheep farming. Seeing the sight of exporting thousands of sheep with just a few farmers and sheepdogs is so eye-catching that it probably won't let you down. Next, it is a goat herd in Australia. Although not as large as the sheep, the number of goats is still very large. Next, we will go to the Netherlands. A country with blanket farms raise giant pigs. The Netherlands is a country with a very developed livestock and crop farming industry. In 2019, the Dutch agricultural sector once again exceeded the previous years with total output of 94.5 billion euros.
With your contribution, we will try to improve the quality and content of the video to meet your needs. We look forward to receiving your feedback on this video. Please leave your comments below in the comment section. Don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel to support us. Thank you and see you in the next videos.